So, a few months ago, Phil Libin and I had a conversation about his startup, and a couple of weeks ago, they reached out to see whether I'd be into doing a partnered bit of content. So today, we're going to do a feature spotlight on some of the features that make special and dig into how you can use it to upgrade your meetings, reduce your meetings, and also make better recordings, and really to enhance that and make it super engaging. So we're gonna dive into that in today's video, and I think this should be a fun segment because we're gonna break it into three parts. You can naturally find which one is most suitable for you in the timestamps below. So welcome, my name is Francesco. I naturally have been covering productivity tools for some time. So when it came on my radar, obviously I knew what it was and thought it was a fantastic tool. So if you're interested in downloading it after the video, you can find that linked below. But the first segment I want to talk through is upgrading your meeting, because when you're having a meeting, it's naturally very stale these days, but meetings digitally have become quite stale. But naturally, want to upgrade that by doing a few engaging things. So you can use with Google Meet, Zoom, Cisco WebEx, and the likes of Microsoft Teams. And what's nice about it is it's simply just a change of the camera, and it goes into the camera app that you use with And what's awesome is you can basically change your background, add presentations, add slides, make your background more engaging with visuals like GIFs, secondary cameras, and screen sharing. And here's a good example of me using it inside of a Zoom meeting. And you can see how simple it actually is to switch between cameras and then jump and change elements as you're in the meeting and move yourself around. Is that a song? And naturally make the meeting much more engaging. Now, why is this cool? It's not only cool because if you're in a team meeting, you could show off stuff much more like naturally, but also if you're showing stuff to a new client that you're taking a Zoom for the first time on, this is gonna wow them. This is gonna be really clean level presentation and look fantastic. So you can prepare everything on in advance, and then naturally the meeting's gonna go as smoothly as humanly possible, especially if you're doing externally facing ones too. And they don't have to download an app, they can just use one of those four applications, and even there are a few more, I believe. So it also improves internal meetings because it makes them much more engaging, and you can also do icebreakers as well, which make the meeting go a lot more interactively, especially if you're remote and you're trying to boost that engagement when you do have meetings. So talking about when you do have meetings, want to reduce the amount of meetings you have, and they're gonna do that by making sure you can record your meetings that you create, which not only allows those who are not there to attend, but also those who are there to come back to that meeting and really take a lot more layers in. And that's great for all of the team so that you don't have additional meetings or just overload the calendar. And what's nice as well is you can have custom sequences too. And there's a secondary feature that's quite beneficial because once you've got it all out there, there's audience insights, which mean when other people are watching these recordings back, you can see who engaged and what comments they left and things like that, so that you can see who's caught up and who hasn't, so that you can nudge them maybe if it's something important. And finally, better recordings. Want to make these recordings fantastic. So I mentioned the presentation function. You can actually import PDF and PowerPoint, which means you can make those presentations from something you've already had. If you are somebody that wants to improve the engagement in a meeting, but already has a system of doing it, then you can import that. And what's cool as well is if you're in a team, you can have a video library, which means that video library can be accessed and really taken advantage of. And also they work with subtitles, which means you can see everything at a glance in multiple languages as well, which means that you can set up the captions function too, which is great for a more a team that is broadly available across the world. Other elements I really like about this is here's a good example of me using the GIF function. You can always use a screen share function as well, and you can use a secondary camera, which means that if you want to just have a camera that's over the desk as you're visually explaining something as a team, or you're in the office with a bunch of you, but someone's at home, then you're not gonna be able to miss out on that because somebody can have a secondary camera and show off all the goods. So that was a little bit about the three ways that can enhance meetings, reduce meetings, and improve asynchronous meetings. So of course, This application will be available in the link in the description, but if you're interested in going deeper on it, they have a full website and insights into how you can use it into your routine. So thank you to Mhm for sponsoring this feature. That was quite hard doing the video just saying Mhm all the time. but naturally, I hope you enjoyed it and it gave you a bit of insight into how you can use the app to enhance your meetings. So thank you very much. Thank you to Mhm, and I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio.